throughout the day, secure video conferences took place among the National Security Council, the Department of Justice, the Department of State, the Department of Defense, the Department of Treasury, FEMA, CIA, the FAA, and other federal agencies. Both the President and the Vice President presided over a number of cabinet and sub-cabinet meetings and video conferences. Continuity of government plans were put into effect. Within the Department of Justice, our full resources were put into operation immediately. As I will explain in greater detail in a few moments, these resources have been deployed both to investigate this act of war and to assist victim survivors and victim families. But let me stress that this is not simply a Department of Justice effort. The response of the federal government across the board has been, I believe, from the President of the United States to the rescue workers, magnificent. I'll now turn to the information that the response we have been making has developed. I'll give you the information that we can give you. However, we will give you only facts that we can confirm. You may be hearing things that we have not told you, but some people have the luxury of speculating. We won't speculate, but we'll only give you confirmed facts. And also, we must be careful to protect confidential intelligence sources and the methods of our intelligence so we do not compromise this ongoing investigation or the capacity of this nation to undertake such investigations as this. The four planes were hijacked by between 3 and 6 individuals per plane, using knives and box cutters, and in some cases making bomb threats. Our government has credible evidence that the White House and Air Force One were targets. A number of the suspected hijackers were trained as pilots in the United States. The Department of Justice has undertaken perhaps the most massive and intensive investigation ever conducted in America. The full resources of the FBI, the Justice Department's Criminal Division, the U.S. Attorney's Offices, the INS, and other components have been brought to bear and will be focused in this endeavor. Throughout the day and into the night last night, Deputy Attorney General Larry Thompson and Assistant Attorney General Michael Chertoff, who is not with us at this moment, and I were present at the FBI's Strategic Information and Operations Center, together, of course, with the director and a number of other individuals. The Justice Department is working closely with investigators, the FAA, and the intelligence community, including the CIA, the NSA, the Defense Intelligence Agency, and the Defense Department. Numerous agencies have assigned personnel to the SIOC at the FBI to coordinate investigative efforts so that information which is received on these premises becomes immediately available to the cooperating agencies. And I might add that we reciprocate with similar deployments in a variety of other settings. The Justice Department's Terrorism and Violent Crime Section is coordinating the response of the U.S. Attorney's offices nationwide. These agencies have a presence at the SIOC here in the FBI 24 hours a day and are coordinating efforts both in the United States and worldwide around the clock. Investigators are reviewing intelligence and have received numerous credible leads. Command posts have been established at all crime scenes. Evidence response teams and the FBI's disaster squad have been deployed to the crash sites. The recovery of bodies and the collection of evidence is ongoing at the Pentagon and at the crash site in Somerset County, Pennsylvania. Investigators are working with the National Transportation Safety Board to recover the black boxes from the crash sites. The crime scene at the WTC has been secured, but is not yet a crime scene accessible to investigators. The United States Attorney's Office's terrorism units and the FBI's Joint Terrorism Task Forces are obtaining the passenger manifests, rental car receipts, telephone logs, and videotape from parking garages, and pay telephone videotape records at all scenes for review and appropriate follow-up interviews. All investigative resources of the FBI's laboratory and crisis response capabilities have been mobilized. Now let me turn this podium over to FBI Director Bob Mueller to talk more about the investigation itself.
Thank you, Mr. Attorney General. I want to start by saying that the men and women of the FBI join the nation in expressing our deep sympathies for the victims of these horrific tragedies and their families. And we, all of us in the FBI, pledge to those directly affected by these attacks that we will leave no stone unturned in our quest to help find those responsible and to bring those individuals to justice. Let me turn, if I could, for a moment to the effort that we have undertaken at the FBI to investigate these tragedies. Early after the planes started to fall yesterday, as soon as we heard that there was a particular city that was either a city of origin for a flight or a city such as New York where a flight went in, we established command posts. We have at those command posts and at a number of offices around the country where there are leads, more than 4,000 special agents who are assigned to assist this investigation. 4,000 special agents and 3,000 support personnel. We have over 400 of our laboratory personnel deployed at the crime scenes in New York City, south of Johnstown in Pennsylvania, and at the Pentagon. And we anticipate this level of resource commitment will continue for the immediate future. In the last 24 hours, we have been addressing two objectives. The first objective is to identify the hijackers on each of the planes. Having identified the hijackers on each of the planes, we then have sought to identify any of their associates remaining in the United States. Our first effort is to identify any associates in the United States who might be related to the hijackers and to remove those associates, investigate, and arrest, given the evidence, those individuals, and to remove any threat to the air system in the future. That is our first objective. The second objective is to gather any and all evidence we have as to whom assisted the hijackers, and not only in this country, but also overseas. We have, in the last 24 hours, taken the manifests and used those as an evidentiary base, and have talked to many of the families of the victims, and have successfully, I believe, identified many of the hijackers on each of the four flights that went down. We also have identified, through a number of leads, principally at the cities of origin, a number of individuals whom we believe may have had something to do with the hijackings, and we are pursuing those leads aggressively. Let me conclude at this juncture by emphasizing again the FBI's total and unwavering commitment to this investigation. We will not stop, and as I said before, we will leave no stone unturned until we have determined who was responsible for these attacks on our freedom. Now, I would be happy to entertain questions, as I'm sure the Attorney General would.
Director, have there been any arrests of any of these associates to identify the
Now, I understand that there is reporting out there that the FBI has made arrests with regard to the hijacking. That is not accurate. There have been occasions where we have interviewed individuals and come to find that the individual is out of status, and that individual has been detained on an immigration hold. But there have been no arrests relating to these hijackings at this point.
You might talk to and the people that you've identified. Are these people that have been under FBI's watch in the past relating to other kinds of terrorism activities? Are they people who you're familiar with?
As we identify names, there may be one or more individuals with whom we have information as to involvement with individual terrorist groups.
We've seen activity today in Boston, Rhode Island, and in southern Florida. Can you walk us through, in any of these cases, and give us any guidance on why these particular individuals have been stopped and what the FBI is doing?
We have in Boston, my understanding also in Providence and also in Miami, we have leads indicating the presence at some point in time of either the hijackers themselves, and we are attempting to recreate the travels of each of the hijackers on the planes, either the hijackers themselves or their associates. And consequently, we are following all leads with interviews, with search warrants, and whatever investigative techniques are necessary to obtain the evidence.
How many? How many associates, Ms. Mueller, do you think? And how many were workers at the airport?
I can't give you a definitive number on the associates.
Have you linked this to Osama bin Laden?
Thank you very much.
There you have FBI Director Mueller, who was joined earlier by the Attorney General, outlining what is being described as the most massive and intensive investigation ever conducted by the Justice Department. And he revealed a few what he said are facts that they have come to count on, that they were 3 to 6 hijackers for each plane, and they had such weapons as knives, box cutters, and in some cases made bomb threats, he said. He confirms what we have been hearing from other sources, that White House and Air Force One were, according to Mr. Mueller, targets of yesterday's action, although obviously neither of those entities was hit, and that the hijackers, some of them, were trained as pilots in the United States. Mr. Mueller portrayed what appears to be considerable progress so far in the investigation, saying that they believe they have identified many of the hijackers, and in some cases, others who may have had something to do with the hijacking as well. We, of course, have been covering this afternoon, considerable flurry of activity up in New England. You saw the scene outside the Copley Plaza Westin Hotel there in Boston, where police had descended according to some reports, arrested several people. No arrests, said Mr. Mueller. There's an FBI news conference going on in Pennsylvania now. We're going to join that as we await the beginning of Ari Fleischer's briefing at the White House. Let's listen.
Need for information in terms of the specifics, the capabilities of the items shown here, feel free to call the NTSB at their headquarters at 202-314-6100. Again, we're looking for human remains, aircraft parts, the black box, and other items of evidence. I want to take some time to express our gratitude to representatives of the Salvation Army and the American Red Cross, as well as other organizations who provided us with support here on site. As you can imagine, we're working long hours to try to address this issue of the processing of the crime scene. again, for information regarding attacks that occurred in New York and Washington, you can call 866-483-5137. If you have any information to provide to us, you can call the FBI Pittsburgh office at 412-471-2000.